You're watching Weather Center Live. Right now, we do have a severe thunderstorm warning in North Carolina. Earlier, it was a tornado warning. Right now, it has since weakened. But for those areas that you're seeing, the cities of Buford, as well as Morehead City and Newport, this goes until 9 o'clock Eastern time. So really, just a couple more minutes, really, even less than a minute before it expires. Right now, Winter Storm Olympia putting more than 25 million people under winter weather alert. But even Florida has had a very rough start to the morning. A reported tornado may have possibly pushed through the region. We have two views, one coming out of Miami, and then we have another view earlier of the storms rolling through. You can see frequent lightning as well as, again, tornado warning earlier. So that's a look at the severe weather side. We go from that. We talk more about Winter Storm Olympia and how much snow it's been putting down. As I said earlier, 25 million people under some type of alert.
That's right. And we're still keeping an eye on the winter side of this story, too, because that's still also a very big impact. You're looking now live at Watertown, New York, who incredibly had one of the coldest low temperatures we saw over the weekend. And then again, we also had a live look there earlier from Burlington, Vermont. But Jen, you've got a closer look at the current radar of what we are dealing with right now.
Yeah, that's right. We want to show you exactly what is happening with Winter Storm Olympia. And we do know this time yesterday, we were starting to see a lot of that precipitation changing over to rain. And as we show you, we do have a lot of rain. You can see where the winds are converging. But what we have is actually snow on the backside. All that cold air in place and that warm moisture just going through and dumping out a tremendous amount of snowfall in some of these parts. Even for Syracuse, I've already picked up 9 inches of snowfall and it's still snowing. It is not done yet. Here's the view. 9 a.m. Buffalo, you got snow around. Pittsburgh, the same for you. But if you go just to the east for State College, you're looking at rain and heavy rainfall as indicated by the yellow. You can see those temperatures in the mid to upper 30s. That's keeping it rainfall. But for areas to the west, we have those temperatures stuck in the 20s like Dunkirk, as well as Rochester, Bradford, 31 degrees. Maybe if you're driving on the highways today, this is going to be tough because this is actually not that lake effect snow. This is actually coming from the low over towards the east, and it's that heavy, wet snowfall that is coming through. So that's a live view of what's happening on the radar. Right now, we want to turn it over to our own Mike Seidel. He is live in Buffalo this morning. And good morning to you, Mike. It looks like we're going to be looking at more of that heavy snowfall. And of course, the winds are coming into play. What an incredible view this morning.
We have a lot of snow out here, Jen. In fact, just got the latest 9 a.m. Eastern observation from Buffalo International, Niagara International at Cheektowaga. They've had another inch of snow in the past hour. That's 5 inches. Wait, let me get 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. That's 6 inches in 5 hours in Buffalo. Even better, Rochester has come in with another snow increase, which we used to call in the weather tower at Penn State a snocker, another 2. So they've had 2, 2, and 2. They've had 6 inches in 3 hours in Rochester. East of here, that band has been dumping all the way down to Dansville, into Jamestown, across the southern tier, and now up towards Watertown. So that's where we're going to have the biggest totals. Not that 6 inches in 5 hours isn't too shabby. Let me take you back to this morning before sunrise, and this is Buffalo. This is the professionals out here shoveling and plowing. Even saw a school bus. A lot of schools are closed for a break this week, but some did open, some did close, the ones that were supposed to be in session today. But we did see that school bus and folks out bright and early here at Lafayette Square in downtown Buffalo. Let's go out to the thruway. Thruway is open despite the snowfall. We don't have a tremendous amount of wind. These are 10 to 15 mile an hour winds, and we're not getting the 3 to 4 inch an hour snowfall rates we typically get with lake effect. You can see 90. You can see some of the road surface and traffic is moving very slowly here in the metro Buffalo area. By the way, Buffalo gets about 2/3 of its snow from lake effect. So this is a pretty healthy storm from a synoptic scale standard. This is a storm that's going to go right up just to our east. So we're just barely in the cold air. In Syracuse, they've had freezing rain overnight and this morning. That has cut way down on their snowfall accumulations. Out here on the trolley line where they've hit the horn a few times on me, they've plowed this very heavily. You can see folks getting around. The roads are, you know, snow packed and snow covered, still snowing at least a half an inch an hour. A couple folks out here. Hey, you heading to work?
Yeah.
You heading to work?
Yes.
Are you local?
Pay bills.
Are you from?
Pay bills.
You're going to go pay bills?
That's right.
Well, see that sign over there?
That's right.
See that lottery sign?
I'll see it.
The Powerball, $189 million.
Hey, man, we don't play Powerball.
Okay, yeah. Okay. Good to see you.
All right.
There you go, guys. So people out here, you know, dealing with the weather. It's not particularly cold. 28 degrees in Buffalo. We're only 5 degrees below the average high. So this is a fairly moderate day by Buffalo standards. But the big thing, Jen, is coming into the storm, they'd only had 35.2 inches, half of their seasonal snowfall today. So we're kind of digging into the deficit here in Western New York. Guys?
And thank you so much. That was Mike Seidel reporting live from Buffalo. So let's take a look at what areas are going to expect for the remainder of this storm in terms of how much more they expect to get. Notice cities like Buffalo, maybe even like East Cleveland, Erie, Pennsylvania, down to Pittsburgh. We're talking about 1 to 3 inches. Then you go to places kind of in an upper state. New York may have about 5 to 8 inches, but we will still have some areas that pick up about 8 to 12 inches. Again, ice is still going to be a concern with this particular storm as well. The darker shade of pink, almost like the purple color, is going to be less than 1/10 of an inch. And just as we told you yesterday, 1/10 of an inch can still create a thick enough glaze on the roads to cause slick driving problems and also stick to your car too. But some areas, including just west of Augusta, around Albany and Syracuse, we could see as much as 1/4 of an inch again. And that causes other problems of its own, especially if it starts to weigh down some tree limbs. Here's a look at the radar. Let's put this into motion. Notice on the eastern section of this, it's all rain. Where the cold air is on the backside of it, that's where we're seeing the snow, the freezing rain, the sleet that's going to go with it. But as we go through the afternoon, it begins to shift off to the north, and more of the rain begins to make its way a little bit closer to Interstate 81 in upstate New York. Then we begin to go up towards Burlington. Again, you're going back and forth between some winter precipitation, then to rain, and then maybe a little bit more snow on the back edge once it finally wraps back around as we go into the evening hours tonight. And we still will see some isolated light snow showers later this evening, but for the most part, most of the system should wrap up before then. Here's another look at Pittsburgh. Again, we have some snow showers expected into the morning, but once we get into the afternoon, things finally start to dry back out a little bit. And then, Jen, we can finally begin to make the transition into maybe spring, perhaps?
Yes, we like to see spring-like temperatures, but the good news is we are going to see a huge swing in those numbers actually ahead, plus tornadoes caught on video in the south. The latest on where today's severe weather threat is next. And here's a live look at State College, Pennsylvania. Students are walking around in the snow. We'll be right back.
Where can you satisfy your craving for a delicious 100% Alaskan cod meal? Right here at Long John Silver's. Enjoy our tasty two-piece hand-battered Alaskan cod basket, hand-dipped in our classic batter, now for just $5.99. Because at Long John Silver's, you deserve more.
These are my dogs, Dusty and Cooper. I work for the dogs 24/7. I am the butler. These dogs shed like crazy. It's like being inside of a snow globe. It takes an awful lot of time to keep the house clean. I don't know what to do.
What's this?
Swiffer, sweeper, and dusters?
This is nice and easy, boys.
It really sticks to it.
It fits into all the tight spaces.
This is really great. Does that look familiar to you? I'm no longer the butler. I'm just one of the guys.
At Safelite, we know how busy your life can be.
Oh, no.
This mom didn't have time to worry about a cracked windshield, so she scheduled at Safelite.com. And with Safelite's exclusive On My Way text, she knew exactly when I'd be there. Hi, Steve with Safelite.
Thanks for your text.
I replaced her windshield, and she didn't miss a single shot, giving you more time for what matters most. How'd you do?
We won.
Nice. That's another Safelite advantage.
Thank you so much.
Safelite repair, Safelite replace.
What average underwear feels like. What Duluth Trading Buck Naked Underwear feels like. Duluth Trading Buck Naked Underwear feels like wearing nothing at all. No pinch, no stink, no sweat. Get a pair, only at DuluthTrading.com.
Can cold weather help you live longer? Is the cure to cancer in the Andes Mountains? Can video games make your brain younger? An exploration to the far corners of the world, seeking the secrets to living longer, healthier lives. Living Longer, Living Better, a special series this week on Today.
Currently in our area, 67 degrees under cloudy skies. Today, a stray shower or thunderstorm is possible early. Cloudy skies early, followed by partial clearing. High 81. Tonight, partly cloudy. Low 58. Winds west-northwest at 5 to 10 miles per hour. Wednesday, sunny skies. High 78. Here's our 7-day outlook.
When the going gets tough, the tough keep pulling.
Stop! All new episodes of Highway Through Hell, Sunday nights at 10 on the Weather Channel.
Yeah!
Haven't seen Maggie in months, sitting in with time on my hair. Seat warm, but rust is all that feels real anymore.
Not driving drives you crazy. Get covered and go at safeauto.com.
From the moment they wake up, doers don't stop. Every day is a chance to do something great. And for the ones they love, they do anything. Sears Optical has glasses made for doing. Right now, buy one pair and get another free. Quality eyewear for doers. Sears Optical.
If I want to go up.
Hello.
If I want to go down.
No.
But then if I want to come back again, it's perfect.
My favorite part is to be able to lift your legs up a little bit and it feels like I'm just cradled.
Change your sleep. Change your life. Change to Tempur-Pedic.
Never underestimate the power of Energizer. Our longest lasting Energizer Max ever.
And welcome back. Winterstorm Olympia transforming Buchanan, Virginia into a winter wonderland. Jason Reinhardt snapped this picture while he was out for a walk yesterday. You can see some of the water frozen, it looks like. This is the Old Mill Dam in Botetourt County. It looks amazing covered in the snowfall. You know, when you go out for a walk on days like this, you are committed.
You are, yes. Because, although, you know, the thing of it is, it's also what you're used to. Mm-hmm. Maybe he grew up there. Maybe yeah. This is just an average February for him. It's not a big deal. But that frozen stuff that you're seeing uh-huh. there, that won't last long because we're going to start to see a temperature change here very quickly. In fact, take a look at some of these temperature changes we have here. Look at New York. In 24 hours, they're going to be 33 degrees warmer today than they were yesterday. We're talking almost 40 for cities like Philadelphia mm-hmm. and Boston, and even, say, Buffalo, where it's only 10 degrees. It's still better than what they would have been yesterday or even over the weekend.
Yeah, I mean, it's impressive when you look at that 24-hour change from just this time yesterday. Binghamton, 40 degrees warmer, and we're going to see the warm temperature setting up across parts of the Northeast and a lot of areas, but we will see those temperatures climbing into the 50s today, and that's nearly a 50-degree difference just from Monday morning. And joining us on the phone right now from Taunton, Massachusetts, it's Glenn Field, a warning coordination meteorologist with the National Weather Service in Boston. Good morning to you, Glenn. It has been a crazy winter, and now we're going from one extreme to another extreme.
Good morning. Yes, we have quite the warm front across our area right now. It's 53 degrees here in Taunton, 52 over in Willimantic, Connecticut, and just a short way to the west, only 29 in Hartford, Connecticut. So, but that warm front will be lifting north across the entire region today, giving everybody about 50 degrees. And our main concern for today is the potential for damaging winds, actually. As temperatures get up to near 58 here in southeast Massachusetts, we'll get a little unstable. And at 5,000 feet above the ground, the winds will be screaming from the south at close to 100 miles an hour between 4 p.m. and 8 p.m. Now, that's not at the ground. That's 5,000 feet up. Mm-hmm. But that's about the same time we're expecting a line of heavy showers and maybe even a thunderstorm to come through. And those could drag down some gusts to 50 or 60 miles an hour down to the ground. So we do have a high wind warning in effect for eastern Massachusetts and Rhode Island.
And how do you think that will impact? Because you were saying the peak timing for those is likely going to be around 4 to 6 p.m. So do you think that will have a big impact on, say, rush hour commutes later today?
It could. I mean, it's better than snow.
But yeah.
There could be some tree limbs flying around, so we're going to have to be very careful.
Yeah, absolutely. And we're certainly going to be looking at some problems with air travel delays. And Glenn Field with the National Weather Service in Boston, we want to thank you so much for joining us and enjoy those warmer temperatures once we get this line of storms to get out.
That's right. So let's take a quick look at your Northeast regional forecast. Mm-hmm. Got a couple live cameras to look at. First is Niagara Falls. Then we're going to take another look at Pittsburgh. You can see, well, not much of anything on either one of those cameras. cameras. We obviously have a little bit of some fog. We have the precipitation coming through. But this is what happens when you have that temperature change a lot of times, especially a quick temperature change that we're seeing. You can see we do still expect to have some snow showers around the Buffalo area. So obviously Niagara Falls would be included in that. Pittsburgh going to be dealing with some snow showers off and on. Probably not going to be consistent throughout the day. You'll get some breaks in between, but your temperatures aren't really going to be all that warm. Take a look at the difference between Pittsburgh and Philadelphia. 33 for the high, or 35 for the high versus 59 for the high. A huge spread there, just in the exact same state. But no worries, Western Pennsylvania, because you will warm up as well. It's just going to be a little bit later than the eastern half of the state.
Yeah, some of those big differences in temperatures, just really 20, 30 miles apart. Well, coming up, Winter Storm Olympia has produced snow, ice, and severe weather this week. Coming up, where scenes like this played out yesterday, and if the threat will continue today, we already know. This morning, we started off with several tornado warnings. And here's a live view of Miami. Speaking of fog and visibility issues, reportedly sustained some storm damage earlier this morning. We're going to be checking back in across parts of Miami. But today, there's that threat still for severe storms.
These little guys, they represent blood cells. And if you have AFib, an irregular heartbeat that may put you at 5 times greater risk of stroke, they can pool together in the heart, forming a clot that can break free and travel upstream to the brain, where it can block blood flow and cause a stroke. But if you have AFib that's not caused by a heart valve problem, Pradaxa can help stop clots from forming. Pradaxa was even proven superior to warfarin at reducing the risk of stroke in a clinical trial without the need for regular blood tests. And in the rare event of an emergency, Pradaxa is the only oral blood thinner other than warfarin with a specific reversal treatment to help your body clot normally again.
Pradaxa is not for people who have had a heart valve replacement. Don't stop taking Pradaxa without talking to your doctor. Stopping increases your risk of stroke or blood clots. Ask your doctor if you need to stop Pradaxa before any planned medical or dental procedure. Pradaxa can cause serious and sometimes fatal bleeding. Don't take Pradaxa if you have abnormal bleeding. And seek immediate medical care for unexpected signs of bleeding like unusual bruising. Pradaxa may increase your bleeding risk if you're 75 or older, have kidney problems, stomach ulcers, a bleeding condition, or take certain medicines. Side effects with Pradaxa can include indigestion, stomach pain, upset, or burning.
Don't just go with the flow. Go with Pradaxa, the only blood thinner that lowers your risk of stroke better than warfarin and has a specific reversal treatment. Talk to your doctor about Pradaxa today.
Pure is big, bold, and just better. Pure is McCormick. The smallest pinch of Pure McCormick can make meals legendary. We want to help you realize the rich taste that Pure can bring, because Pure tastes better.
What you doing?
Just prepping for my boss's party in a couple weeks.
What are those?
Pressed white strips. They whiten way better than paste.
Crisp 3D white strips whiten 25 times better than a leading whitening toothpaste.
I'd say someone's making quite an impression.
Crisp 3D white strips, the way to whiten.
We know you have a morning routine. We have one too. 7 days a week, AMHQ is right here and weather ready with Jim Cantore, Stephanie Abrams, Jen Carfagno, and the rest of AMHQ.
Let's get right to what you want, and that is the weather.
AMHQ, every morning starting at 5 on the Weather Channel.
Brought to you locally by South Florida Ford. Go further. Online at southfloridaford.com.
When excess mucus and phlegm accumulate in your lungs, you get congested. You need relief that works from the inside out. Now, available to call the Phlegm Ejector. To call is a multi-symptom cold syrup that works fast. Its triple action formula relieves cough, loosens mucus, and clears congestion. It makes your cough more productive from the inside out, so you can feel better faster. If you don't get the relief you expect, your money back. To call the Phlegm Ejector.
Available at these stores.
When the going gets tough, the tough keep pulling. Stop!
Oh, oh! All new episodes of Highway Through Hell, Sunday nights at 10 on the Weather Channel.
Yeah!
Currently in our area, 67 degrees under mostly cloudy skies. Today, a stray shower or thunderstorm is possible early. Cloudy early with some sunshine this afternoon. High 81. Tonight, some clouds. Low 59. Winds west-northwest at 5 to 10 miles per hour. Wednesday, sunny skies. High 78. Here's our 7-day outlook.
Welcome back. Right now, we look across parts of the southeast. Very active continues across parts of South Florida. We have a line of storms trying to depart out of Miami, but heads up for you if you're in the Keys or into Homestead, as well as Key Largo. We have two views out of Morehead City, and as well as one coming out of Miami. Rough conditions as we go up to the north, including parts of North Carolina. We actually had a reported tornado warning there as well. We actually saw on the radar mesovortices as well with the embedded tornado. So it was pretty impressive when we saw that move on shore. You can kind of see some of the older loop of that breaking its way across parts of North Carolina. On the wider view, there is our line, and we'll continue to see more heavy rainfall as we go throughout the day. North Carolina looking at the threat for severe weather as we continue throughout the day. And as you can see for those temperatures today, they start off in the 50s, but we're going to warm up this afternoon. Those are our highs today, 61 degrees in Atlanta and 72 in Jacksonville.
That's right, and at least 10 tornadoes were reported to have touched down across Florida's Panhandle and Mississippi yesterday. Here are a few videos from across Florida where we supposedly had some of those. And obviously, the National Weather Service crews will be out to try to survey some of those to find out whether or not they actually were, and if they were, what strength they would have been.
Yeah, that's right. You know, it's been so very active this season across parts of Florida. Those are your three views. Now, we show you, that's the bottom screen, the Century, Florida. That's a rural town about 50 miles from Pensacola. The National Weather Service says they're going to send the team out later on today, and they're actually going to be following the track northeast into Alabama. And we take a look at some more video. This is of damage coming out of areas, including parts of Florida, as well as into Alabama. And this video is showing you even that some of the restaurants were actually dealing with some damage.
That's right. You can kind of see. And then you see some people kind of lined up there. You know, obviously, you have to kind of form lines when you get the injuries to make sure you treat the most urgent people first. And I would not be surprised. You look at all those dots, the red ones and the blue ones that are on the radar. That's all the storm reports that we were able to get from some of these storms that we had yesterday. But that line, we're likely going to see more of those dots in Florida and parts of the Carolinas today from the storms that we've had this morning. So this storm system is not yet over completely.
That's correct. And we have some more video actually coming out of Century, Florida. Local residents say at least 10 homes were damaged there. There were no reports of any injuries, but you can see some of the roofing, some of the siding being flipped over into a pickup truck. Things just twisted around. All signs that tell of the strong damage that came through.
That's right. And a 94-year-old woman is expected to recover, thankfully, after neighbors pulled her from the wreckage of her home. This was in the Florida Panhandle, again, around that Century, Florida area. A suspected tornado damaged at least 10 of those houses in that town. There you can see them kind of trying to lift her and kind of take her. Everybody clapping. Obviously, at least she is alive at this point, which is always the best news.
Yeah, you like to see the community come together, but all that debris that's left behind, this is incredible amount of damage there. Well, the damaging winds blew through parts of central Louisiana yesterday, as well as two people were working at a Pizza Hut when they were hit by winds that actually blew the roof off of a car wash onto the restaurant. Now, one woman was waiting to pick up a to-go order when a piece of the building fell on her car. Now, in Jefferson Davis Parish, there was also reports of a tornado that moved through an open field. Luckily, no damage was reported there. We were here live yesterday when we start to see all these reports coming out yesterday. Now, this is out of Copiah County. That's just south of Jackson, Mississippi, where residents say they saw a tornado touch down and rip apart a home.
The damage was so severe in parts of that state, but the good news is only minor injuries were actually reported out of it. And it's incredible to see, like, that is a brick structure right there. Again, you know, sheds, barns, those kind of things you expect to get tossed around because they're not very sturdy structures. But when you see things like that were built with concrete and stone and brick, and for those to be damaged, that just tells you how impressive the storms really were. Well, Winter Storm Olympia, the same storm that caused some of that damage, is still going strong now as it begins to shift north.
And coming up, the latest on the timing and the impacts and where up to a foot of snow is possible for today. The snow is still coming down. We'll let you know if it's in your area.
And also, we will have Mike Seidel coming up to join us with a live look from Buffalo. Temperature 30, but poor Mike, it only feels like 21 degrees right now.
At least he's not shoveling.
New Tidy Cats Lightweight 4-in-1 fights mess right. Attacks three strong litter box odors. Plus, locks clumps tight. And now, it's light. Every home, every cat. There's a Tidy Cats for that.
Tour of Italy at Olive Garden, starting at $12.99. Choose three of 10 favorites to enjoy on one plate, plus unlimited salad and breadsticks. The best tour of Italy is the one you create at Olive Garden.
Don't miss Founders Days at Pep Boys. Get 5 quarts of Castrol or Pennzoil conventional oil, plus a Fram oil filter for only $9.99 after mail-in rebate. And when you buy 3 select tires, you get the 4th free instantly. Trust the boys to get you there.
My clear solution for pain, Salonpas Jet Spray, powered by 2 medicines. Salonpas sprays on clear, dries fast, and provides up to 8 full hours of relief.
Salonpas, powerful relief when and where you need it.
Abdominal pain. Urgent diarrhea. You never know when IBS-D will show up.
Now there's prescription Xifaxan. Xifaxan is a new IBS-D treatment that helps relieve your diarrhea and abdominal pain symptoms.
Do not use Xifaxan if you have a history of sensitivity to rifaximin, rifamycin antibiotic agents, or any components of Xifaxan. Tell your doctor right away if your diarrhea worsens while taking Xifaxan, as this may be a sign of a serious or even fatal condition. Tell your doctor if you have liver disease or are taking other medications, because these may increase the amount of Xifaxan in your body. Tell your doctor if you are pregnant, plan on becoming pregnant, or are nursing. The most common side effects are nausea and an increase in liver enzymes.
If you think you have IBS with diarrhea, talk to your doctor about new Xifaxan.
Every auto insurance policy has a number. But not every insurance company understands the life behind it. Those who have served our nation have earned the very best service in return. USAA. We know what it means to serve. Get an auto insurance quote and see why 92% of our members plan to stay for life.
We know you have a morning routine. We have one too. 7 days a week, AMHQ is right here and weather ready with Jim Cantore, Stephanie Abrams, Jen Carfagno, and the rest of AMHQ.
Let's get right to what you want, and that is the weather.
AMHQ, every morning starting at 5 on the Weather Channel.
Currently in our area, 67 degrees under mostly cloudy skies. Today, a stray shower or thunderstorm is possible early. Cloudy early with some sunshine this afternoon. High 81. Tonight, some clouds. Low 59. Winds west-northwest at 5 to 10 miles per hour. Wednesday, sunny skies, high 78. Here's our 7-day outlook.
Closed captioning brought to you by Beltone, your premier hearing care partner.
Beltone is conducting a new trial on innovative hearing technology. You will be asked to evaluate a remarkable product that's virtually invisible. Call 1-800-BELTONE.
Here's a live look at Pompano Beach, Florida. Again, possible storm damage there from this morning's system that kind of pushed through. Just now starting to get a lot of the reports in, but there you can see the roof kind of ripped up and blown over parts of these buildings. Look, clearly that building has more than two-thirds of the roof just completely ripped off. And again, some of the cars, you're seeing some damage. I see numerous windshields that have just been blasted out. And obviously, Jen, a lot of debris scattered everywhere.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, when you're looking at video like this, and we do know earlier this morning that we were tracking our tornado warning earlier, and you see the video, it's obvious that this is a sign of some very strong storms, and the signature was just a brief one that spun up. But it looks like, in fact, I think we are going to be seeing something like this confirmed as we go later into the day.
That's right, and thank you so much for sticking with us on Weather Center Live. Good morning. It is just half past the hour. I'm meteorologist Allison Chinchar.
And I'm meteorologist Jennifer Delgado. Of course, we are tracking Winter Storm Olympia, and it's bearing down across parts of New York this morning.
That's right. One of the hardest hit areas, Buffalo, where they've seen more than 3 inches of snow just in the last couple of hours. That's, of course, where we find our own Mike Seidel. Good morning to you, Mike. How are the conditions looking now compared to just a couple
hours ago?
Hey, good
morning, Allison. Look at this. We're piling the snow up. It is adding up here in downtown Buffalo. I mean, we've seen bigger piles in Buffalo. Remember November a year ago when we had 7 feet in a couple of days? Nothing like that, but pretty healthy storm. Now, that was lake effect. This is not lake effect. This is a synoptic scale low. Low pressure going up just to our east. So we're in the cold air, but the East Coast cities, the big cities, which we'll talk about throughout the afternoon, and Reagan Medji will be live in New York starting around lunchtime. They're going to have rain and wind. They may have some wind issues and wind damage. Get more on that later on. Back here, the wind's not an issue. We're down here on the trolley line, the light rail. This is a beautiful part of Buffalo down here at Lafayette Square. Traffic is moving along, inching along down here around the square. Roads are snow-packed and snow-covered. The plow comes by as much as it can. We've had 6 inches of snow in 5 hours through 9 a.m. Eastern. Rochester, 6 inches in 3 hours. So we've had the what we call S-plus heavy snow, 2 inches an hour. That's a pretty good snowfall rate. It's still 28 degrees. It's been there all morning. And get this, this time last year, Buffalo had already had their seasonal average. They were up at 96 inches. That's 8 feet of snow. This year, going into the storm, only 3 feet of snow so far. So we're making up for lost time as we clean the lens down here and try to give you a better visibility. Visibility has improved down here. We're up to about a mile or so. The airport at 9 was down to a quarter. That's going to start coming up. And there's your hourly forecast. Things improving mid to late afternoon. The storm pulls away. The snow tapers off. The winter storm warning officially right now goes till 7. Jen?
All right, we'll be watching that until 7 o'clock tonight. Of course, we want to time out Winter Storm Olympia for you. And there you have it, Mike Seidel reporting live. Let me tell you, he is a trooper, always out there in those snowstorms or rainstorms. He's just like the postman, right? All right, let's talk more about Winter Storm Olympia and what we could see. About another 1 to 3 inches for areas, including the western parts of PA, including New Pittsburgh. But if you go up to the north, as well as in the western parts of New York, that's where we're going to see heavier amounts of snowfall. Look at the regions. For regions, including right along 80, we'll be picking up potentially another 5 to 8 inches of snowfall. Keep in mind, some areas already have a foot of snowfall coming down from Winter Storm Olympia. So here's a live look at the radar. We've added in the temperatures for you. Pittsburgh, you're right at the freezing mark. Notice the 20s for Buffalo. State College, 34 degrees. Here's the rainy side, but notice it is icy in Albany with those temperatures right now holding right around the 30-degree mark. So as we go throughout the day, that warm air is going to continue to nudge through. You can see those winds kicking in that moisture. As this goes from 12 o'clock tonight to the time you're driving home later on this afternoon, this is 3 o'clock. Some storms moving through areas like New York as well as into Albany, and then eventually making into regions like Boston. Boston as we go 6, 7, 8 o'clock at night. Expect to see some strong winds, but then of course we'll see that snowfall going away, but we'll also be dealing with those strong winds, especially some of those gusting up to 50 miles per hour. But it's not all bad out there, Allison.
No, and it's only going to get better from here, especially in terms of the temperatures. Let's take a look. So as we start off the week, we see clearly still have a lot of the cold air across the Midwest and the Northeast. That warm air, which has been stuck in the West Coast for several weeks now, bringing record high temperatures, that's going to begin to shift as we go over the next couple of days. Notice it starts to move over the south central portion of the country. The jet stream also, instead of having those deep ridges and troughs, is going to become almost zonal in a sense, where you really don't have the extremes on either side. Really, the entire southern half of the country will be dealing with temperatures that are 15, 20, even sometimes more than 20 degrees above normal. The cold air staying well up into Canada. We're talking, look again, highs 10 to 30 degrees above average. Most of that intense heat is going to be located in the central portion of the country, but even still, Phoenix, Bismarck, Chicago, even Atlanta are still going to be dealing with temperatures well above normal. Here's a look at some of the records. Amarillo, Texas, we're forecasting 87. The old record is 80. We're talking about blowing this record out by 7 degrees. Lubbock, Texas, 87 to 83. El Paso, also going to be very close to their record. And it's not just in Texas. We're talking Rapid City, South Dakota, could be about 2 degrees off from their record. Topeka, Kansas, again, same thing, about a 2 degree spread. But you know what, Jen, even if they don't actually break the records, I think they'll just be happy to finally not be below freezing or near zero in a lot of these spots.
You're absolutely right. They'll take anything they can get, especially when you're talking about temperatures almost 30 degrees above average. But for more on that extreme swing in temperatures, let's go inside weather with WSI senior meteorologist Dan Leonard. And Dan, of course, you know, we talked so much about the cold yesterday. Let's talk about some of the good stuff that's coming. The big, huge warm-up, record warmth possible.
Yeah, Jen, as we saw Allison showing, it's going to be amazing this weekend. I think there's going to be a lot of spring fever in the air for most of the eastern half of the nation. All that warmth that she showed in the central part of the country, that ejects eastward as we get a short wave that goes across the Great Lakes and up through New England. So anywhere south of that storm track, it's going to get really warm this weekend. We're talking 60s and 70s, a lot of record warmth. But I think the real question is, what happens after this? Are we really done with winter? Is this the last big cold shot, or is this a temporary warm-up, and we'll get back into cooler temps as we get beyond next week? And right now it looks like the latter, where we'll start to dig the trough back into the eastern half of the country once we get beyond Monday or Tuesday of next week. So even though we have a temporary shot of warm weather this weekend, and it's maybe Monday or so for most of the country, it doesn't look like a persistent warm pattern will develop. In fact, we'll probably get back to near or even slightly below normal temps in the eastern third of the country next week.
Now, Dan, one question for you, because when you go back and forth between a lot of these things, especially because we have spent a good portion of the month at or below normal, when the month is finally over, said, and done, these little quick bursts of warmth, do you think they'll have much of an impact on averaging out the month when it's all said and done?
Yeah, Allison, that's a funny point, because when we look back on this, historically speaking, we're probably going to look at the month as a whole and say, eh, it really wasn't that interesting when we look at the cumulative mean of the entire month. But you really have to break it down into weeks. You go from an extreme warm week during the first week of the month to extreme cold second week, now back to a warm week, potentially back to another cold week. So in the end, a lot of places might end up pretty close to average for the entire month, but that really doesn't tell the story of these big troughs and waves that we've had in the pattern.
Yeah, it doesn't tell the pain and the suffering. I want to ask you very quickly about next week. You mentioned the 24th. We already know there's going to be a front around, cold air in place. Talk it.
I like it. I think this is a good setup, Jen. If we have a strong Gulf wave, it looks like, will develop at the same time a polar high comes down from Canada. The amount of cold air is really in question, but I don't doubt right now that there will be some sort of an East Coast system Tuesday and into Wednesday of next week. So something definitely to watch.
All right. I'm going to have to get a calendar. I'm going to have to go old school
to mark it down.
Everything that Dan Leonard tells us. That's Dan Leonard with WSI. Thank you so much. Of course, we will talk to you again tomorrow.
That's right. And now we take a look at some live aerials out of Pompano Beach, Florida. I want to take a look at some of the damage that's just now starting to come in. This, what looks like, the clips, it's clipping out a little bit, but it looks like it's of a little bit of a regional airport in the area. We'll have more details coming up after the break.
Currently in our area, 69 degrees under cloudy skies. today, a stray shower or thunderstorm is possible early. Cloudy early with some sunshine this afternoon. High 81. Tonight, some clouds. Low 59. Winds west-northwest at 5 to 10 miles per hour. Wednesday, sunny skies. High 78. Here's our 7-day outlook.
Across America, people like Basketball Hall of Famer Dominique Wilkins are taking charge of their type 2 diabetes with non-insulin Victoza.
For a while, I took a pill to lower my blood sugar, but it didn't get me to my goal. So I asked my doctor about Victoza. He said Victoza works differently than pills and comes in a pen. Victoza is proven to lower blood sugar and A1C. It's taken once a day, anytime. Victoza is not for weight loss, but it may help you lose some weight.
Victoza is an injectable prescription medicine that may improve blood sugar in adults with type 2 diabetes when used with diet and exercise. It is not recommended as the first medication to treat diabetes and should not be used in people with type 1 diabetes or diabetic ketoacidosis. Victoza has not been studied with mealtime insulin. Victoza is not insulin. Do not take Victoza if you have a personal or family history of medullary thyroid cancer, multiple endocrine neoplasia syndrome type 2, or if you are allergic to Victoza or any of its ingredients. Symptoms of a serious allergic reaction may include itching, rash, or difficulty breathing. Tell your doctor if you get a lump or swelling in your neck. Serious side effects may happen in people who take Victoza, including inflammation of the pancreas, pancreatitis. Stop taking Victoza and call your doctor right away if you have signs of pancreatitis, such as severe pain that will not go away in your abdomen or from your abdomen to your back, with or without vomiting. Tell your doctor about all the medicines you take and if you have any medical conditions. Taking Victoza with a sulfonylurea or insulin may cause low blood sugar. The most common side effects are headache, nausea, diarrhea, and vomiting. Side effects can lead to dehydration, which may cause kidney problems.
If your pill isn't giving you the control you need, ask your doctor about non-insulin Victoza. It's covered by most health plans.
If you have moderate to severe rheumatoid arthritis like me, and you're talking to a rheumatologist about a biologic, this is Humira. This is Humira, helping to relieve my pain and protect my joints from further damage. This is Humira, helping me reach for more. Doctors have been prescribing Humira for more than 10 years. Humira works for many adults. It targets and helps to block a specific source of inflammation that contributes to RA symptoms.
Humira can lower your ability to fight infections, including tuberculosis. Serious, sometimes fatal infections and cancers, including lymphoma, have happened, as have blood, liver, and nervous system problems, serious allergic reactions, and new or worsening heart failure. Before treatment, get tested for TB. Tell your doctor if you've been to areas where certain fungal infections are common, and if you've had TB, hepatitis B, are prone to infections, or have flu-like symptoms or sores. Don't start Humira if you have an infection.
Talk to your doctor and visit Humira.com. This is Humira at work.
Building the only truck with the best fuel economy. An award-winning engine. You got that fire. And a 9,200-pound towing capacity. Takes guts. Overcoming any obstacle, that's the glory. Get a great deal on the trucks that give you both during Ram Truck Month. Now get 0% financing for 60 months, plus up to 2,000 truck month bonus cash on 2016 Ram 1500 trucks.
I have asthma, one of many pieces in my life. So when my asthma symptoms kept coming back on my long-term control medicine, I talked to my doctor and found a missing piece in my asthma treatment.
Once daily Breo prevents asthma symptoms. Breo's for adults with asthma not well controlled on a long-term asthma control medicine, like an inhaled corticosteroid. Breo won't replace a rescue inhaler for sudden breathing problems. Breo opens up airways to help improve breathing for a full 24 hours. Breo contains a type of medicine that increases the risk of death from asthma problems and may increase the risk of hospitalization in children and adults.
bronchoalescence. Breo is not for people whose asthma is well controlled on a long-term asthma control medicine, like an inhaled corticosteroid. Once your asthma is well controlled, your doctor will decide if you can stop Breo and prescribe a different asthma control medicine, like an inhaled corticosteroid. Do not take Breo more than prescribed. See your doctor if your asthma does not improve or gets worse.
Ask your doctor if 24-hour Breo could be a missing piece for you.
See if you're eligible for 12 months free at mybreo.com.
Some new video in from earlier today of storm damage across parts of Florida. This is out of Pompano Beach, Florida. Look at this huge tree that is torn over to its side, lifted up from its roots. We've had live aerial coverage of this throughout the morning, and we continue to see more damage like this. But we're hearing that reportedly, according to WTVJ, 27,000 people without power across Broward County, and then for Miami-Dade, 28,000. And we saw this early this morning when these reported tornadoes came ashore.
Yeah, the tornado warning came in at 7:53 this morning Eastern Time, and it wasn't really in effect for very long because it quickly went out to sea. But it just goes to show you they don't have to be on the ground for very long to cause a significant amount of damage. And again, you can see numerous trees down. We've got
everywhere.
Damage. There's some fence that's been ripped up there. Here's another view. Again, you can see the roofs on some of these buildings and sheds that are just ripped up and thrown. Some of those pieces, because you can tell from the colors that where they look like they would match. Some of them look like they're several. Probably 50 to 70 feet. It's kind of hard to gauge distance there, but they're picked up and just tossed quite a distance. So again, very impressive.
Yeah, we see this, and we did check earlier. We do know that tornado season has been very active across parts of Florida for this time of the year since January. Reportedly, what, 20 tornadoes?
20 tornado reports so far just since January 1st of this year. Again, that's an incredible number, knowing that we're only midway through February.
Yeah, and you know, the other thing too, a lot of these coming in the morning hours. I know we've tracked at least 4 different cases of this on our show over the last couple of weeks. This is video about a Hallandale Beach, a tremendous amount of rainfall, the strong winds, even if you weren't maybe possibly part of where we saw the tornado warning earlier, but this whole area sustained a tremendous amount of wind damage, and we're going to continue to follow this story as we go throughout the day.
That's right, and here you can see again some of these. It looks like the boat kind of flipped over there from some of the strong winds. And one thing to note, that video you're just showing with all the wind, you know, that does this stuff, you know, where it can pick up stuff on the water and blow it over palm trees. There's a reason why they're in the south. They talked about this earlier this morning, if you saw it at AMHQ. They are meant to withstand strong winds like this, and they even had parts of their branches being ripped off. So it's no wonder you can then see stuff like this being flipped over in the water.
And this photo right here coming from the Fort Lauderdale Fire Police Department, and it shows actually some boats that were flipped over. One person had to be rescued by the fire department, as the pictures were sent in to us just a short while ago. So, you know, you would hope people would stay out of the water. Some people possibly don't pay attention to the forecast, but when you see a line like this coming through, you certainly have to get out of the water. Not even just for just tornadoes, possible water spouts as well.
That's right. Again, I think it's kind of like you said, though, people, we don't always think of these things as happening early in the morning, but they do, especially this time of year. Again, let's take a look at the radar recap of the storms. You can kind of see that in the right-hand side of your screen. Again, as those storms kind of came through, they were very, very quick. Again, most of these being in and out within less than 2 hours as they kind of came through. There you can see just as they passed over both Fort Lauderdale area having a reported tornado and a couple then just on the north side of Miami. Obviously, the National Weather Service will go out and kind of survey those storms later today.
Yeah, not very far away from Interstate 95. And we're also hearing reports of a possible tornado at the Lighthouse Point area. Now, the National Weather Service, Miami, they still have to go out and survey the damage, but it wasn't even just Florida alone today. We also had that report earlier of what looked to be a pretty good signature across parts of North Carolina. So the threat is going to continue as we go through the day for Florida, as well as even for parts of North Carolina, especially as we go through about the noontime hour.
That's right. And again, it's not just the severe side of the storm. We still have the winter side of Storm Olympia, and we'll have that latest timing and what the rest of the impacts will be, and some places had more than a foot of snow by the time we'll be done with the day today. We end with a live look in Duluth, Minnesota. Here you can see at least the sun is, Jen, attempting to make a try.
It's trying to come out, but it feels like 15 degrees. Dress warmly.
can you satisfy your craving for a delicious 100% Alaskan cod meal? Right here at Long John Silver's. Enjoy our tasty two-piece hand-battered Alaskan cod basket, hand-dipped in our classic batter, now for just $5.99. Because at Long John Silver's, you deserve more.
We brought you here today to get your honest opinion about this new car. To keep things unbiased, we removed all the logos.
Feels like a BMW.
Reminds me a little bit of an Audi.
So this car supports Apple CarPlay.
Siri, open maps. Wow. She gets me.
It also has teen driver technology. It even mutes the radio until the seatbelts are buckled.
I'm very curious what it is.
This is the 2016 Chevy Malibu.
And it sells for?
It starts at $22,500.
What?
Oh, wow. I mean, all this technology.
That's a game changer.
Blizzard of 1978, the one moment that made me a weather geek. When I was a kid, I just was fascinated at the weather. I was fascinated how, you know, I go to bed one night and I look outside and everything is dry. Wake up the next morning, poof, talking close to 2 feet of snow. Wow. Like, how did that happen? And I was just at awe at what was happening with the atmosphere. And I was hooked ever since.
Currently in our area, 69 degrees under cloudy skies. Today, a stray shower or thunderstorm is possible early. Cloudy early with some sunshine this afternoon. High 81. Tonight, some clouds. Low 59. Winds west-northwest at 5 to 10 miles per hour. Wednesday, sunny skies. High 78. Here's our 7-day outlook.
Vitamins A and C, and only 50 calories a serving. Good morning indeed. V8, veggies for all.
Is this really the best way to pick color for a whole room? There's a new way to paint. With the new Project Color app, take any color on a virtual test drive. It's part of the new Color Center experience from the Home Depot. Everything you need to get the right color, right. In hand, online, and at the store. Guaranteed one coat Behr Marquee, just $40.98. Download the Project Color app. The Home Depot. More saving, more doing.
If you could see your cough, you'd see all the sickness you're spreading. New Robitussin CF Max Severe soothes and delivers powerful relief of cough, sore throat, stuffy nose, and fever. New Robitussin CF Max Severe, because it's never just a cough.
New Tidy Cats Lightweight 4-in-1 fights mess right. Attacks three strong litter box odors. Plus, locks clumps tight. And now, it's light. Every home, every cat. There's a Tidy Cats for that.
Here in the city, parking is hard to find. Seems like everyone drives. And those who do should switch to GEICO because you could save hundreds on car insurance. Oh, perfect. Valet parking. Hello.
Evening, sir.
Here's the keys. And go easy on the right, mate. Wouldn't mind some of that beef Wellington.
To see how much you could save on car insurance, go to GEICO.com.
At SafeLight, we know how busy your life can be.
Oh, no.
This mom didn't have time to worry about a cracked windshield, so she scheduled at SafeLight.com. And with SafeLight's exclusive On My Way text, she knew exactly when I'd be there. Hi, Steve with SafeLight.
Thanks for your text.
I replaced her windshield, and she didn't miss a single shot, giving you more time for what matters most. How'd you do?
We won.
Nice. That's another SafeLight advantage.
Thank you so much.
SafeLight Repair, SafeLight Replay.
When you're in pain, an hour seems like a day seems like a month.
Resolute Pain Solutions offers same-day, next-day appointments for evaluation and treatment. Our pain management specialists have the knowledge and experience in state-of-the-art procedures to relieve pain and get you moving. Patients in pain no longer have to endure unnecessary suffering while waiting for an appointment. Resolute Pain Solutions. Stop hurting. Start living today. Visit ResoluteMD.com/TV.
Hey, how's it going? Hotcakes? Hotcakes.
This place has hotcakes.
Hotcakes.
So why aren't they selling like hotcakes? With Comcast Business Internet and Wi-Fi Pro, they could be. Just add a customized message to your Wi-Fi Pro splash page, and you'll reach your customers where their eyes are already, on their devices.
Order up.
It's more than just Wi-Fi. It can help grow your business. You don't see that every day.
Introducing Wi-Fi Pro. Wi-Fi that helps grow your business. Comcast Business. Built for business.
When the going gets tough, the tough keep pulling. Stop!
All new episodes of Highway Through Hell, Sunday nights at 10 on the Weather Channel.
Yeah!
Good morning, back in Buffalo, meteorologist Mike Seidel. The snow adding up now at least 6 inches on the ground. There goes the trolley, the light rail. Business as usual here in Buffalo, although it hasn't been snowfall-wise. They've only had about half of their average for the season to date. They should be up at 6 feet. They've had 3 feet until today, so we're eating away at the deficit. Traffic crawling down Court Street, down towards the Niagara Circle and the courthouse. Temperature 28 degrees. We'll come back at the top of the hour. We'll have an update on those snowfall totals from here in Rochester. It's really just a small portion of New York State that's in the wintry weather. Jen?
That's right. But, you know, the snowfall rates have just been so impressive in some of these locations, picking up 1 to 2 inches per hour. Well, right now it's time for your winter weather update. We want to break down some of the numbers and how many more inches we can expect as we go throughout your morning as well as your afternoon. We look at areas like Buffalo. We're expecting another 2 inches. Even from the start of the show, you can see on Mike Seidel's live shot, the snow is starting to taper off a little bit. But notice for Rochester, we're looking at 6 inches. And if we go up towards the north, that's where we're going to see more of that snowfall, especially just north of that 90-86. That's where the heavier snowfall is coming down. Now, as we move that ahead and we show you as we go through even tonight, 3 to 5 inches. Watertown for you going to be right on that line to 5 to 8. But overall, Lake Erie as well as Ontario, that's where we're going to see the areas just to the east of that. It's going to be that heavy, wet snow. One's going to be really hard to kind of shovel, what they call that heart attack snow. As we look for Syracuse, here's your forecast. Expect to see some rain around from 10 o'clock all the way through 2 o'clock. Rain for you. You'd rather have the rain around instead of the snow, but the problem is that snow kicks in right around 4 o'clock and continues until 10 p.m., so that is going to lead to some problems as you're heading to bed. As we show you on a wider view what's happening for State College as well as Syracuse, all these temperatures actually above freezing. However, in Albany, 31 degrees, had some reports of some icing there, and then the 20s, the cold air is certainly over towards the west, and we've just been throwing that moisture in from Olympia. Now we go across parts of the Midwest. We have St. Louis as well as into Jefferson City. This is where we have rain as well as mixed in with at times some of that icing setting up. This is moving into southern parts of Illinois. Paducah, heads up for you. Looks like right now rain, but overall this is our clipper that's going to be moving, and it's going to jump about 1 inch of snowfall. Nothing too incredibly impressive, but overall this is going to lead to some problems on the roadways. The good news is for St. Louis, you're at 36 degrees, so rain for you, and your temperatures will continue to warm up. As we track this clipper, it's going to make its way over towards the east, and you can see overall some areas might pick up a little bit of some snow setting up, but overall it's going to be pretty quiet. However, it will bring in another push of that cold air. And then eventually, by the time you head into Thursday, you're going to start to see those temperatures warming up. Allison, speaking of the Midwest, how about some numbers?
Yeah, let's take a look at it. We'll start off with a live look in Iowa City and also into St. Louis. Again, you can see we do still have some snow on the ground, especially into Iowa City. But look at the temperatures right now, 32 in Cincinnati, 30 in Indianapolis. But we will be warming up. We go from, say, 35 degrees with cloudy skies in Des Moines, and then we start to see that transition of that warmer air as the wind begins to shift, so that by this afternoon, Des Moines, you're just about a degree below normal. But look at Minneapolis and Kansas City. We're starting to see that warming trend, even if it is just a few degrees, given another day, because tomorrow, that's when you're really going to start to see a lot of the warmth. Look at Des Moines. We go from 35 today, 35 tomorrow, to a 20 degree jump, yes, on Thursday. And we're talking 60 by the time we get to Friday, 60 and sunshine. Sometimes you get one or the other, but you don't get
both. You're getting them both.
The
two for one. special.
Indeed. So this weekend going to be fantastic in Des Moines, Jen.
That's absolutely great news for those folks there. Well, we look at St. Louis right now, and people walking around still looking at some snow on the ground. We'll let you know when the snow is actually going to be moving out of parts of the Northeast.
That's right. Plus, another active day of severe weather in the South. We'll break down where the threat of severe storms actually will continue for the day today. We have some live aerials again to show you from possible damage this morning. This is out of Fort Lauderdale. Jen, I'm not really sure what that is. It looks somewhat like a raft, but maybe a trampoline.
Possibly.
Yes, obviously we're along the beach. You can see some of the boats. It looks like some chairs have been flipped over as well there. Again, just kind of going to show you, you can see all the debris there that they're trying to pick up. Chairs and tables they're trying to pick up and pull back in along the beach. We'll have more details on it and the rest of the damage coming up.
We continue to track severe weather moving through parts of the Outer Banks. We have a severe thunderstorm warning in effect for counties of mainland Dare. This goes until 10:30. And you're seeing these lines of storms, a bright band, and you can see that orange. This is indicating where we have the stronger winds that are trying to move through.
And they're moving very quickly, too, about 60 miles per hour. So at least one positive side is they'll should be out of here pretty quickly as they continue to slide over. But right now, Winter Storm Olympia, the northern edge of this, where we're dealing with all of the winter precip, it's putting more than 25 million people under some type of winter weather alert, including towns like Watertown, New York, Erie, Pennsylvania, Burlington, Vermont, and we have a couple of those here to show you. And again, all of them, Jen, having some coating of white along all of them that you can see. Erie, Pennsylvania, again, at least the roads are clear. That's good to know. Watertown, New York, by the way, they've got the snow, but they were down to minus 37 over the weekend. So obviously, temperature improving a little bit as we go through the day today. And then Burlington, Vermont, we've had some cold weather. But all of these places, Jen, are going to be warming up, not just temperature-wise, but we'll see that transition to rain as well.
Yeah, that's right. We do know those temperatures are going to change that over. And we started to see this yesterday, especially in the evening hours. And you can see across parts of Pennsylvania as well as New York, we have rain. You can see those winds converging there. And then if you look over towards west, where we have our snow coming down, all that cold air in place, and we're just whipping that moisture through, and that is producing the snow across parts of western New York as well as PA. But if you notice to the west, we have our temperatures that are much cooler. We have the lower 30s as well as the upper 20s. You go over towards the east, we have those temperatures right at the freezing mark. And that's why we're seeing more rain around for areas like State College and the same for Syracuse. However, Albany reporting icy conditions. If you look real closely, you can see the purple indicating that threat for the ice. Now, as we look across areas to the west for Dunkirk as well as into Buffalo, a lot of this action happening right along Interstate 90 as well as into 86. So maybe if you're in Bradford, take it slow. We look at some of these darker shades of blue right near Rochester. That's where the heavier snowfall is coming down at the moment. As we go throughout the day, we'll continue to see a couple more inches of snowfall. Right now, we're going to turn over to Mike Seidel, and he is live in Buffalo, New York. And in Buffalo, you're dealing with the wind. You've been dealing with the heavier snowfall. I mean, just getting hammered over there, Mike.
Well, the wind's only been running at about 10 to 12 miles an hour, so that really hasn't been an issue here. But we have been hammered by snowfall. I just got the 10 a.m. observation in from Buffalo International. They didn't report a snow increase, so it was less than an inch, I'm thinking. So they've had six plus in 6 hours. Meanwhile, Rochester picked up another inch between 9 and 10 Eastern. So now they've had 7 inches of snow in 4 hours. That's amazing. The heavier amounts have been just out to our east, not far from where it changes to freezing rain, sleet, and then to rain. To get over to Syracuse right now, last check, 32 rain and freezing rain. So that really has cut down on any snowfall. Their snow ended very early this morning, not long after midnight. Downtown, traffic moving very slowly. You can see the roads are snow-packed and a snow cover. Not only here, but let's take you to one of our DOT cams out on the New York State Thruway, which is open. You can see it's snow-packed, not a whole lot of traffic. A lot of schools are closed this week. The ones that were open, some of those closed, some of those had a two-hour delay, and the snow continues to add up, but it is lightening up. It's not snowing as hard as it was. The visibility out at the airport now has come back up to a half a mile. Speaking of the airport, 14 departures canceled. That's about 15% of their flights out of here. So not a huge interruption, but again, remember, this is Buffalo. These are the professionals up here. Allison?
Thank you so much, Mike Seidel. That's live from Buffalo. So let's take a look at how much more this snow these areas could end up getting when this system is all said and done. Cities like Pittsburgh and Syracuse, likely another 1 to 3 inches. We've got areas like Watertown that could end up getting, and maybe say even around the Buffalo area, about 3 to 5 inches. But take a look at Rochester, this tiny little cluster right here. We're talking could see an additional 5 to 8 inches of snow before this system moves out, but it's not just snow. Probably the bigger threat, again, is still that freezing rain and ice accumulation. All of these areas you see in purple, including State College, Boston, and Augusta, could pick up around a tenth of an inch of ice. That will provide a thin glaze along your sidewalks, your streets, even your cars and your vehicles could end up having that glaze pre-built onto things like the tires and the rest of your car. So be careful with that. Give yourself some extra time in the morning. You may have to kind of scrape some of that off. Also, up around Albany and Syracuse, we could see slightly higher amounts. We're talking up to, say, about a quarter of an inch of ice accumulation in those areas. Here's a look again, around lunchtime, we've got that kind of that southeasterly wind kind of being brought up and more of a southerly flow into Philadelphia. So you've definitely got that warmer air bringing in, which is why Philadelphia will be pretty much all rain for the entire day today. So along Interstate 95, if you have problems to deal with, it's just going to be in the form of rain. Different story along Interstate 90, also along 81, where you're going to have that mix at times going throughout the day, especially as we get into the evening. Those temperatures, again, are going to drop after nightfall. So Buffalo, Pittsburgh, also up around Erie, you could still be dealing with some of that mix later on this evening. Once we get to late Tuesday night, though, most of the precipitation finally starts to move out, the heavier rain, in fact, now into parts of Maine and then eventually moving up into parts of Nova Scotia and well out into the Atlantic. Here's a look at the breakdown for Pittsburgh. Again, for this morning, we only really have a few extra hours where we really have some good snowfall coming down. The rest of the day will remain mostly cloudy. Then once we get later on into tonight, they have some of that wraparound coming back. But overall, the key thing to note, a lot of these places, look at the snow, enjoy it while you can, Jen, because in about 3 days, it's going to be all be gone.
Yeah, that's good news with those temperatures warming up. We're going to talk more about that. Plus, we're going to have the very latest on where today's severe weather threat is, and we're going to continue our coverage of what's been happening across parts of South Florida. Here's some video of the rain and the winds blowing through. Reportedly, a tornado may have touched down in two separate places across parts of Florida, and we have live aerial view coming out of South Florida. This is out of Fort Lauderdale. It's hard to see there, but let me tell you, we've seen a lot of damage with some damage along the beaches as well as some of the buildings. We'll continue our live coverage as we continue to get our feed coming in from WTVJ. And also, we had a report of a tornado also in parts of North Carolina. Here's a live view of State College, Pennsylvania, 35 degrees. We'll be right back.
When you're living with diabetes, steady is exciting. Only Glucerna has Carb Steady, clinically proven to help minimize blood sugar spikes. So you stay steady ahead.
These are my dogs, Dusty and Cooper. I work for the dogs 24/7. I am the butler. These dogs shed like crazy. It's like being inside of a snow globe. It takes an awful lot of time to keep the house clean. I don't know what to do.
What's this?
Swiffer, sweeper, and dusters? This is nice and easy, boys.
it really sticks to it.
It fits into all the tight spaces. This is really great. Does that look familiar to you? I'm no longer the butler. I'm just one of the guys.
Women are taking on bladder leaks in a new way with Poise Impressa bladder supports.
I experience leakage when I sneeze,
when I cough,
when I walk the dog. When I heard about Impressa for the first time,
I really questioned if this could work.
After seeing the science behind it, it made sense.
Kind of looks like a tampon, just puts a little bit of pressure on the urethra.
It helps stop it from coming out.
I'm back in control. That's something I never thought I would ever have.
See why 9 of 10 women said their bladder leakage was reduced or stopped at Impressa.com.
That was unexpected. But you always know exactly what to expect when you have Amica Auto Insurance.
Personal attention and great service every time you call.
Call for a free quote now. You can save up to 15% when you combine auto and home insurance with Amica. Remember, the unexpected can always happen. So call Amica and expect great service every time.
We know you have a morning routine. We have one too. 7 days a week, AMHQ is right here and weather ready with Jim Cantore, Stephanie Abrams, Jen Carfagno, and the rest of AMHQ.
Let's get right to what you want, and that is the weather.
AMHQ, every morning starting at 5 on the Weather Channel.
Currently in our area, 70 degrees under cloudy skies. Today, a stray shower or thunderstorm is possible early. Cloudy early with some sunshine this afternoon. High 81. Tonight, some clouds. Low 59. Winds west-northwest at 5 to 10 miles per hour. Wednesday, sunny skies. High 78. Here's our 7-day outlook.
Episodes of Highway Through Hell, Sunday nights at 10 on the Weather Channel.
Yeah!
Now you can create your own tour of Italy at Olive Garden, starting at $12.99. Choose 3 of 10 favorites to enjoy on one plate, plus unlimited salad and breadsticks. The best tour of Italy is the one you create at Olive Garden.
Ha! Building the only truck with the best fuel economy. An award-winning engine. You got that fire! And a 9,200-pound towing capacity takes guts. Overcoming any obstacle, that's the glory. Get a great deal on the trucks that give you both during Ram Truck Month. Now get 0% financing for 60 months, plus up to 2,000 truck month bonus cash on 2016 Ram 1500 trucks.
Big, bold, and just better. Pure is McCormick. The smallest pinch of Pure McCormick can make meals legendary. We want to help you realize the rich taste that Pure can bring, because Pure tastes better.
Well, it looks like sailors in Maryland won't be taking their boats out today. This is what it looks like in Calvert County. This is just southeast of Washington, D.C. Karen Murphy tweeted us this picture of the Flag Harbor and Marina. And this is a really nice photo here. You can see they actually had a quite a big amount of snowfall, 7 inches.
Yeah, again, you can kind of see it piled up there on the boats. And the other question, too, is I wonder how close some of that water may have perhaps frozen along the docks and some of the piers. You got to be careful, even if you're going out to your boat, you may slip on some of those docks and stuff that they have. But all of that beautiful snow is likely going to melt here coming up soon. Take a look at this 24-hour temperature jump. D.C., 23 degrees warmer right now than it was at the same time yesterday. Binghamton, New York, it is 39 degrees warmer. We're talking almost 40 degrees warmer right now than we were at the same time yesterday. Very similar for Bangor, Boston, and also into Philadelphia. It's incredible. A nearly 60-degree temperature swing even into Portland, Maine. So what a difference a day actually makes. They were negative 10 yesterday morning. Today, they'll reach a high up around possibly 50 degrees, Jen.
Yeah, we know a lot of the areas across parts of the Northeast are waiting for the warmer temperatures. And joining us right now, we have Justin Arnott, a science and operations officer for the National Weather Service in Portland. Justin, good morning to you. It has been quite a roller coaster ride with these temperatures.
Yeah, absolutely. Record cold across much of the northeastern United States over the weekend, and we're still kind of stuck in it right now, but it's really warm, not that far above our heads right now, and that warm air is going to mix down to the ground today.
Now, Justin, we know that winds are a concern for you guys there, but I've also been noticing in Portland, they've had fog and freezing fog for the last several hours being reported. So how long do you expect the freezing fog to last? Because that could be a huge problem for commuters.
Yeah, temperatures right now still a couple degrees below the freezing mark, and honestly, the fog's really going to last until we start to see that warm air mix down, and that's really probably, you know, noon or shortly thereafter, we're going to start mixing it away at the coast, and then that will gradually improve as we move inland.
And we do know, of course, those temperatures are going to warm up, but we're also going to be looking at those winds getting really gusty throughout the day. I know you're talking about those mixing down. Explain that a bit more.
Well, there's going to be winds not that far off the surface this afternoon and this evening that will reach, you know, 75, 80 miles per hour. And so what we're expecting is some of that, a lot of it actually mixed down to the ground. So right along the coastal areas, we expect wind gusts over 60 miles an hour this evening, which can bring with it all the same problems that you see with severe thunderstorms. You know, tree limbs and even some downed trees are possible with power outages, et cetera, as these warm winds bring temperatures up this evening.
Well, thank you so much. Again, that's Justin Arnott. He's a science and operations officer from the National Weather Service in Portland. Thank you so much.
I want to thank you again for joining us. And we're going to talk more about those temperatures warming up for parts of the Northeast. We have to show you some of the good numbers, and we've been talking about it so much. So what will you be looking at tomorrow? Yes, it's still going to be a little bit cooler. On the cool side, but eventually we'll see those temperatures really soaring, especially as we head into Thursday. Right now, we're looking at 59 degrees in Philadelphia, 47 degrees in D.C., a testament to the warm air, all the rain you're seeing on the radar.
That's right, and we showed you the foggy pictures out of Portland, but look, Niagara Falls, Pittsburgh, also just as foggy. This is what happens when you get that temperature swing, where you go from extreme cold to not necessarily extreme warmth, but where you have that rapid warm-up. That's what causes all of these problems. So, again, very similar, some of this fog likely going to stick around.
Yeah, the warm front is doing its job, bringing in that warm air. Well, Winterstorm Olympia has produced snow, ice, and severe weather just this week alone. It's only Tuesday. And coming up, where scenes like this played out yesterday, and if the threat continues today.
Live look out of Miami, Florida. Again, they had some really rough weather this morning. Things finally starting to lighten up a bit. It looks like most of the severe weather now finally off the coast. We'll give you more details on this and the rest of your forecast after the break.
If my hands are dried and cracked, I can't do my job efficiently.
My hands are dry from washing my hands lots of times a day.
O'Keefe's Working Hands. Guaranteed relief for dry, cracked hands.
O'Keefe's works.
I saw it working for my husband, and I knew I had to try it.
Learn more at O'Keefe'sCompany.com.
Don't let the cold damage your skin. Get O'Keefe's Working Hands. Guaranteed relief for dry, cracked skin.
From the moment they wake up, doers don't stop. Every day is a chance to do something great. And for the ones they love, they'd do anything. Sears Optical has glasses made for doing. Right now, buy one pair and get another free. Quality eyewear for doers. Sears Optical.
My mom loves giving me advice. She even gives me advice about my toothpaste and mouthwash. But she's a dentist, so I kind of have to listen. She said, Jen, go pro with Crest Pro Health Advanced.
Advanced to healthier gums and stronger teeth from day one.
Using Crest toothpaste and mouthwash makes my whole mouth feel awesome. And my teeth are stronger, too.
Crest Pro Health Advanced is superior to Colgate Total in these five areas dentists check.
This checkup, so good.
Go pro with Crest Pro Health Advanced.
Mom's right. Again.
We said goodbye to the day and to the city and drifted off into the twilight. And when we woke, we found that the whole world had reinvented itself.
Sail with Princess Cruises, the best cruise line in Europe. Limited 7-day Mediterranean fares from $9.99. Call your travel consultant or visit princess.com. Princess Cruises, come back new.
The all-new Civic from Honda.
We know you have a morning routine. We have one too. 7 days a week, AMHQ is right here and weather ready with Jim Cantore, Stephanie Abrams, Jen Carfagno, and the rest of AMHQ.
Let's get right to what you want, and that is the weather.
AMHQ, every morning starting at 5 on the weather.
At Seaside Palm Beach, we recognize that you may have other obligations in your life. When you're here, you'll be able to bring your laptop. We encourage you to bring your phone. We don't want you disconnected from the rest of the world. Where other treatment centers will not allow you to have these things, we know that you have a life, but we're going to help you live that life better than when you came here. Your transition from chemically dependent to chemical free will be as painless as possible. Seaside, Palm Beach, please come see us.
Hey, how's it going? Hotcakes? Hotcakes.
This place has hotcakes.
Hotcakes.
So why aren't they selling like hotcakes? With Comcast Business Internet and Wi-Fi Pro, they could be. Just add a customized message to your Wi-Fi Pro splash page, and you'll reach your customers where their eyes are already, on their devices.
Order up.
It's more than just Wi-Fi. It can help grow your business. You don't see that every day.
Introducing Wi-Fi Pro, Wi-Fi that helps grow your business. Comcast Business, built for business.
When the going gets tough, the tough keep pulling.
All new episodes of Highway Through Hell, Sunday nights at 10 on the Weather Channel.
Yeah! Currently in our area, 69 degrees under mostly cloudy skies. Today, a stray shower or thunderstorm is possible early. Cloudy early with some sunshine this afternoon.
High 81.
Tonight, some clouds.
Low 59.
Winds west-northwest at 5 to 10 miles per hour. Wednesday, sunny skies.
High 78.
Here's our 7-day outlook.
Back, we look across parts of the southeast. A very active morning. In fact, we still have another severe thunderstorm warning across parts of North Carolina. This is in the area, including just to the west of Cape Hatteras. Now, we do know these are the cities, Columbia, as well as Gumneck and Lake Landing until 10:30. Expect to see some of those gusty winds, especially when you're seeing those lines setting up. And a lot of that's going to be moving to the east. You can see Morehead City. It looks very ominous there. And then for Miami Beach, things look a lot better than they did earlier today. But you can see that line of storms trailing all the way down across parts of Florida.
That's right. It's finally starting to clear out in Miami after what was very much a rough morning for them. We had some severe storms that kind of rolled through southern Florida earlier this morning. Let's take a look at that radar recap that we have, that we can kind of show you what they dealt with this morning as they had some of those. We are noticing the warmer temperatures, and that will continue through the day. But again, a very rough morning for parts of South Florida.
Absolutely. You know, those dew points are up, and even even as we go throughout really the late morning into the very early part of the afternoon, we're going to continue to see that threat of the severe storms. And we look right now at the radar recap. What you're seeing are these red dots. And one is just to the south of Lighthouse Point, and another one just north of Miami. You can see the multiple dots. We think that it's probably very likely multiple reports of a tornado, maybe multiple touchdowns. Of course, we'll continue to follow that. The National Weather Service still has to go out and survey that damage. A lot of the action along Interstate 95. And we do know what, 9 reported tornadoes so far this season for parts of Florida since the beginning of this year.
Confirmed. Mm-hmm. 9 confirmed. They had about 20 reports, but again, most of those are likely multiple reports of the same one, but 9 confirmed tornadoes so far, but that does not include any that would have been in the last 48 hours. So keep in mind, we've already had several reports in the last couple of days. So again, but now we want to get some more details on what has actually happened this morning. So joining us on the phone this morning is Chief Battalion Abe Hernandez. He is with the Miami-Dade Fire and Rescue. Chief, I imagine you've been quite a busy person this morning. Kind of take us through what went on.
Yes, good morning. We had a fast-moving storm with winds in certain pockets in excess of 60, 70 knots, causing many of our brittle, dry trees, because we are in the winter part of the season here in South Florida, and our trees are dry. Mm-hmm. And we've had a lot of damage to the northeast section of Miami-Dade County, consisting of trees being knocked over, power lines coming apart, and several structure fires, building fires or house fires that have been caused by wires down. Adding to that, we've got a large amount of vehicle accidents because the folks were actually en route to their offices, their jobs, when this storm came through and caught them on the roadways. Right now, we've got one of our air rescue units up in the air doing an aerial survey of the northeast section of the county, which seems to be the hardest hit. And we have several of our technical rescue units on the ground also doing a survey. We check for standing water, structural damage to buildings, wires down, and we come up with assessment that helps us guide our rescuers into the area. But right now, it's a total gridlock in the northeast part of the county. But our units are responding continuously to the regular medical calls, the structure fires, and the requests from help from the citizens that may be stuck with a power line down on top of their cars in front of their house.
All right, Abe Hernandez, we're hoping, of course, we can get more updates from you. Maybe possibly we can talk to you after the break. We also want to talk more about apparently a dump truck that actually went off the roadway. We'll continue our coverage of storm damage across parts of Florida right here on Weather Center Live.
Has to be a way. Carry the centimeter, divide by 3.14 something something something. Great Caesar salad!
And now the Name Your Price tool shows people policy options to help fit their budget.
Is that a true story?
Yeah, people really do save an average of over $500 when they switch.
I mean about you inventing it.
I invented the story, and isn't that what really matters? So, what else about me?
Get your own liquid gold. Go on, get! There's gold in them there shells. Liquid gold.
If you could see your cough...
It's just a cough.
You'd see how often you cough all day, and so would everyone else. New Robitussin 12-Hour delivers fast, powerful cough relief that lasts up to 12 hours. New Robitussin 12-Hour Cough Relief, because it's never just a cough.
Carrabba's only knows one way to do Italian. Fresh, made from scratch. And now we've added over 20 new dishes. That's why the entire menu is 20% off, so you can try them all. Carrabba's, this is how you do Italian.
Legend says Thor's hand made a hammer mighty. Well, in some hands, every tool becomes mighty. An all-powerful impact wrench. A supreme on-car lathe. The 4,000 ASE-certified technicians of Firestone Complete Auto Care prove a tool's only as good as the hands behind it. Firestone Complete Auto Care. Whatever you drive, drive a Firestone.
I recommend Nature Made Vitamins because I trust their quality. They were the first to have a vitamin verified by USP, an independent organization that sets strict quality and purity standards.
Nature Made, the number one pharmacist recommended letter vitamin brand.
fast heartburn relief? Try Cool Mint Zantac. It releases a cooling sensation in your mouth and throat. Zantac works in as little as 30 minutes. Nexium can take 24 hours. Try Cool Mint Zantac. No pill relieves heartburn faster.
When you report the weather...
Oh, yes! Yes! Yes!
There are two things you can never forget. A sense of adventure and a warm jacket.
Yes!
L.L. Bean, official outfitter of the Weather Channel.
Listen to that!
Sir, I must advise against this.
No choice, 3PO. My sister's in trouble.
Lisa! What took you so long?
Duracell Quantum lasts longer in 99% of devices, so you can power imagination all day long.
The challenges facing the country never stop. So neither does the U.S. Army. We train, adapt, and get smarter. Every soldier, every unit, every day. Not to keep up with change, but to drive it. Nobody knows what problems tomorrow will bring, but we do know who will solve them.
We know you have a morning routine. We have one too. 7 days a week, AMHQ is right here and weather ready with Jim Cantore, Stephanie Abrams, Jen Carfagno, and the rest of AMHQ.
Let's get right to what you want, and that is the weather.
AMHQ, every morning starting at 5 on the Weather Channel.
Currently in our area, 69 degrees under mostly cloudy skies. Today, a stray shower or thunderstorm is possible early. Cloudy early with some sunshine this afternoon. High 81. Tonight, some clouds. Low 59. Winds west-northwest at 5 to 10 miles per hour. Wednesday, sunny skies. High 78. Here's our 7-day outlook.
Closed captioning brought to you by Beltone, your premier hearing care partner.
Beltone is conducting a new trial on innovative hearing technology. You will be asked to evaluate a remarkable product that's virtually invisible. Call 1-800-BELTONE.
Welcome back. Thank you for staying with us for Weather Center Live. Just almost 30 past the hour, I'm meteorologist Allison Chinchar.
And I'm meteorologist Jennifer Delgado joining us on the phone right now. We were just talking to him before the break. Battalion Chief Abel Fernandez with the Miami-Dade Fire and Rescue. And Abel, can you please tell us a little bit more about some of the damage that you're hearing on the roadways? I heard a report of a garbage truck actually driving off a ramp.
The garbage truck was occurred yesterday in a different municipality in Miami-Dade County. Was handled by Miami Fire Rescue, not attributed to the fast-moving storm we had today.
Okay. So what can you tell us in terms of, I know you said earlier, you know, you guys have been assessing, you know, where you might have some power lines down, where you have debris. What would you say at this point are probably some of the worst roads that people would be traveling on?
Right now, it seems that US 1, Biscayne Boulevard, Ives Dairy Road, Miami Gardens Drive, even areas that are just smaller streets east of I-95 and immediately west of I-95 from the Dade-Broward line down to about 163rd Street seem to be the hardest hit. Again, we're still doing assessments via our one of our air rescue helicopters, and they're combining that with a task force that's on the ground of technical rescue units, other fire trucks, rescues, and personnel that are trained to assess structural damage after a storm. And we come up with a number given that will tell us or an impact of what to expect for continued services in that area.
And now, Abel, crews, mm-hmm. No, I'm sorry, go ahead.
Our crews are finding numerous power lines down, so our energy partners, FPNL, are extremely overwhelmed because they have their crews out, but we maintain a perimeter around the down fire lines, so we keep the citizens safe from walking into a puddle that may be energized or a fence that may be energized from a fallen power line. So both the FPNL and ourselves are extremely busy at this time responding to the normal calls we have, and compound to that the effects of this fast-moving storm.
And Abel, very quickly, I know you need to go. Did you or anyone with your department actually see a tornado?
We did not. We did not see. I'm in an area just west of the impacted area, but we did not see any tornado. What we did have is extreme winds, very, very fast winds. The rain was coming in a horizontal flow. It was something I had not seen like this since probably Wilma, Hurricane Wilma, had come through. It was extremely difficult to even see a couple of feet in front of you. That's how bad this storm was.
All right. Well, thank you so much again, folks. That was Chief Battalion Chief Abel Fernandez joining us. He was with the Miami-Dade Fire and Rescue. Again, thank you so much. But we are still expecting some severe weather today. Now, not necessarily in Florida. It looks like Florida's threat is over. But as we move north along the East Coast, we still have the threat for some severe weather.
Yeah, across parts of the Carolinas. But we want to talk more about Winter Storm Olympia and how it's bearing down across parts of western New York. They're also going to be dealing with the strong winds. But, of course, they're also looking at some snow.
That's right. One of the hardest hit areas so far, Buffalo. They've seen more than 3 inches of snow in just the last couple of hours. That's where we find our very own Mike Seidel. Good morning to you, Mike.
Good morning, ladies, out here in Buffalo. The snow intensity has tapered off. 5 hours, have had 6 inches of snow. And Syracuse has had Rochester has had 7 inches in 4 hours. Over in Syracuse, they're so far east, they're in the warm air. This storm is tracking up way west. Certainly way west of the coast, and that's bringing the very warm air. DC this morning went from 32 to 50 in just 2 hours. So we're lucky enough to be on the cold side if you like snow and you don't want freezing rain or a lot of rainfall. Downtown, this is Lafayette Square. Most schools are out this week because of winter break. You got the plow coming back around here, the little bobcat plow, trying to play catch up here. Snowfall backing off now, certainly not snowing an inch an hour, so they're able to get ahead of this situation down on Court Street and Main Street. This is where the trolley and the light rail, and if you look in the distance, you can see the plow coming right up the rail. Here comes another bobcat. It's an army of bobcats out here, and there's the plow coming up the light rail, keeping the rails clean for the mass transit down here in the downtown Buffalo area. Snow's gonna really taper off this afternoon, probably be done with by about 5 or 6, and then it's just continuing to kind of dig out from what is a pretty healthy snowstorm by Buffalo standards, considering this year they'd only had 35.2 inches until now. So we may do, 8-9 inches. That's a lot of snow. The record day is 6.6, nothing official, but more than likely we have already broken that here in Buffalo. And then by the end of the week, it will get back close to 40 degrees. The average high today here in Buffalo is 33. Jen?
All right, Mike Seidel, take it from there. But certainly, yeah, they are waiting for those warmer temperatures like the 40s. You know, it's so different, too, because we're not talking about lake effect snow. This is all coming from Winter Storm Olympia. So how much more are we expecting? As you can see, for some of these areas, another 3 to 5 inches, especially across areas. You can see just to the eastern parts of Pittsburgh, as well as even into parts of New York, we're going to be looking at rain. But snow, this is where it's all going to be. We have those temperatures in the 20s, above the freezing mark for areas like Syracuse, as well as State College. You're locked in the rain and some very heavy rainfall at that. We timed this out. This is at 12 o'clock in the afternoon. And as Mike said, the snow is going to be coming to an end as we go later into the afternoon, but still at noontime, maybe you're heading out. This is Interstate 90 as well as I-90 into the 86 area. That's where we're going to kind of see the heavier snowfall amounts. And then eventually we're going to continue to see this wrapping and pulling away to the north. But notice that rain continues to win out, kind of edging more of that snow and changing it over to the rainfall. Now look for Portland, Maine. You're going to be looking at heavy rain as we go through 6 o'clock, lining this up, and that means some strong winds. This is going to lead to some delays if you're going to be flying out or even trying to drive around, especially some of those high profile vehicles. By 11 o'clock tonight, things start to settle down, but it's still going to be rather windy. For Rochester, your forecast showing you the snow will stick around through 7 o'clock tonight, and then after that, things get a lot quieter. And then we talk more about some of the winds. This is actually at 11:30. Those winds 35 to 40 already at LaGuardia. Already hearing some reports of some wind delays. This is going to cause more problems as we go through 4 or 5 o'clock. Notice for Boston, 40 to 50 for you. And those winds coming in out of the south as we go into tomorrow, things will start to settle down. We're going to talk more about the big warm-up that everybody's waiting for, Allison.
That's right. Yeah, it's February. This gets to be the time of winter when everybody's kind of over winter and really wants to kind of move into spring. And this week will be a little bit of a tease of that. Here's how we started off the week. Again, we had all of that warm air in the southwest. We've been breaking record high temperatures in Southern California. The cold air pretty much into the eastern half of the country. But notice by the middle portion of the week, this really begins to shift. And the jet stream takes, instead of being such extreme deep troughs and ridges, it kind of becomes almost zonal, where you get not really much of a difference between the west coast and the east coast, really the entire southern half of the country for the most part, even the southern two-thirds of the country will be much warmer than normal. In fact, in some places we're talking 10 to even 30 degrees above normal. And again, it includes Phoenix, Denver, as far north as Bismarck, Chicago, and as far east, say, as cities like Atlanta, again, that are going to be dealing with these well above average high temperatures. And in some spots, when you're talking 20 and 30 degrees above average, you get close to these records. Take a look at this. Amarillo, Texas, we're talking about not just breaking, crushing the old record by 7 degrees. El Paso, Texas, also likely to break their record high. Here's a look at some other areas, because it's not just Texas. Oklahoma City likely going to tie or break their record high of 78 degrees. And Wichita, Kansas, forecast of 78. We're expected to be up around 74 degrees. Here's a look at Chicago. Again, the average high is 36. We won't be there today. We won't be there tomorrow. Probably only a little bit above Thursday. But we will finally be there, and almost 20 degrees above that by Friday and Saturday. We'll have more details on the rest of the storm next.
Currently in our area, 71 degrees under mostly cloudy skies. Today, a stray shower or thunderstorm is possible early. Cloudy early with some sunshine this afternoon. High 81. Tonight, some clouds. Low 59. Winds west-northwest at 5 to 10 miles per hour. Wednesday, sunny skies. High 78. Here's our 7-day outlook.
Underestimate the power of Energizer, our longest-lasting Energizer Max ever.
Building the only trucks with the best fuel economy, best towing, best torque, and best payload takes guts. Overcoming any obstacle, that's the glory. Get a great deal on the trucks that give you both during Ram Truck Month. Get 0% financing for 60 months, plus up to 2,000 truck month bonus cash on 2016 Ram 1500 trucks.
Don't miss Founders Days at Pep Boys. Get $40 off any brake service package starting at $99.99 after mail-in rebate. And when you buy 3 select tires, you get the 4th free instantly. Trust the boys to get you there.
What you doing?
Just prepping for my boss's party in a couple weeks.
What are those?
Crest white strips. They whiten way better than paste.
Crest 3D white strips whiten 25 times better than a leading whitening toothpaste.
I'd say someone's making quite an impression.
Crest 3D white strips. The way to whiten.
These little guys, they represent blood cells. And if you have AFib, an irregular heartbeat that may put you at 5 times greater risk of stroke, they can pool together in the heart, forming a clot that can break free and travel upstream to the brain, where it can block blood flow and cause a stroke. But if you have AFib that's not caused by a heart valve problem, Pradaxa can help stop clots from forming, Pradaxa was even proven superior to warfarin at reducing the risk of stroke in a clinical trial without the need for regular blood tests. And in the rare event of an emergency, Pradaxa is the only oral blood thinner other than warfarin with a specific reversal treatment to help your body clot normally again.
Pradaxa is not for people who have had a heart valve replacement. Don't stop taking Pradaxa without talking to your doctor. Stopping increases your risk of stroke or blood clots. Ask your doctor if you need to stop Pradaxa before any planned medical or dental procedure. Pradaxa can cause serious and sometimes fatal bleeding. Don't take Pradaxa if you have abnormal bleeding. And seek immediate medical care for unexpected signs of bleeding like unusual bruising. Pradaxa may increase your bleeding risk if you're 75 or older, have kidney problems, stomach ulcers, a bleeding condition, or take certain medicines. Side effects with Pradaxa can include indigestion, stomach pain, upset, or burning.
Don't just go with the flow. Go with Pradaxa, the only blood thinner that lowers your risk of stroke better than warfarin and has a specific reversal treatment. Talk to your doctor about Pradaxa today.
Every auto insurance policy has a number. But not every insurance company understands the life behind it. Those who have served our nation have earned the very best service in return. USAA. We know what it means to serve. Get an auto insurance quote and see why 92% of our members plan to stay for life.
When heartburn hits, fight back fast. Tums Smoothie starts dissolving the instant it touches your tongue and neutralizes stomach acid at the source. Smoothies, only from Tums.
Discover Card. I missed a payment.
Oh, shoot. This is bad.
No, we're good. This is your first time missing a payment.
And you've got the IT card.
So we won't hike up your APR for paying late.
That's great.
It is great. Thank you.
At Discover, we treat you like you'd treat you. Get the IT card with late payment forgiveness.
Icy and dangerous travel in the Northeast and Pennsylvania this morning. Roads described as a, quote, skating rink.
Yeah, the skating rink where you don't want it to be. Let's talk to storm tracker Simon Brewer. He is in Scranton this morning. Good morning to you. Had very icy conditions this morning.
Yes, very icy indeed. Very dangerous.
And tell us, you know, about the accidents you saw today. I mean, how many people were involved?
I'm not exactly sure how many people were involved. Quite a few, dozens.
Wait, so you've been driving?
I happened to get trapped in an accident and luckily got out okay.
Okay, so you've been driving most of the night. How bad were the roads overall up until you came to this particular accident?
The roads were not that great before I came to the accident, but when I came to the accident, it was just a pure sheet of ice. And it was a sharp turn, a blind turn surrounded by rock cliffs and going downhill, very steep hill. So it's just a bad combination.
And Simon, okay, I know you are a storm tracker. Is this the first time you've ever been involved in an accident while you're chasing a storm? And, you know, I would imagine a lot of people had to actually make for cover.
It's the first time I've ever been involved in something like this. Usually I come across accidents that happen right in front of me, mm-hmm. cars spinning out mm-hmm. in front of me, cars spinning out behind me, things like that. I've never been in a situation where I came across up in a mountainous area just north of Scranton with a semi-truck blocking the road and all of a sudden just a barrage of semi-trucks plowing into each other right where I was, and I had to run away for my life, and other people had to run away as well and get off the road.
How much damage, Simon, would you say you had to your vehicle?
Actually, my vehicle really didn't receive much damage at all. I had some scrapes on my rims, but that wasn't from any other vehicles. That was from me sliding along a little guardrail, trying to stay away from other vehicles. Uh-huh. And when I came to a dead end, which was this jackknife semi-truck, I thought for sure other semi-trucks coming behind me were just going to pancake my car. But luckily, as this huge pile of semi-trucks built up behind my car and got closer and closer, I finally stopped about 20 feet from my car.
And Simon,
it was almost like a glacier stopping behind my car.
And Simon, are you still on the roadway, or, you know, are there still a lot of cars there, or things been cleaned up?
I was the first vehicle to get out of the pileup, and I think maybe only one other vehicle was drivable that was involved in the pileup. Every other vehicle was pretty much total, like very, very total, very much total. I was very, very fortunate. Once the jackknife semi-truck was pulled out of the way by a large piece of construction equipment, the state troopers and fire department gave me the okay to leave, and now I'm up near Rochester.
All right, so now the question is, since your vehicle is one of the few that was drivable, where do you go from here?
Well, now I'm going to be around the Rochester area shooting heavy snow. The area where I am right now, I'm going about 40, and there's cars around me going much, much faster than that, probably 60. And there's a lot of ice on the road. I don't think people realize mm-hmm. that the past couple days were well below freezing. So the road surface is very cold, even though the air temperature is hovering around 32 degrees. So there's a lot of ice on the road.
Now, Simon Brewer, storm tracker, in Scranton, Pennsylvania, earlier in an accident. He has some great information there saying, hey, take it slow. He is a storm tracker, and he's saying, I'm going 40 miles per hour, and people are flying by. Go slow, because look what's happening on the radar. We're still looking at some of the heavy snowfall and even some icing, Allison.
That's right. We've got them mixing there. You can kind of see up around Ithaca. They've really got almost every color that this map mm-hmm. can show. There's some blue. There's some purple. There's even yellow indicating heavy rain. And when you get that back and forth, the roads, mm-hmm. it kind of, yes, some of it melts, then some of it refreezes, and then some of it melts and then some of it refreezes. And even cities like Rochester, Buffalo, and Dunkirk, where they're just getting snow, it piles up very quickly. And sometimes you can get that base layer that forms like a little sheet of ice.
Yeah, well, the good news is eventually Winter Storm Olympia is going to be out of there, and we're going to trade it in for warm temperatures, Allison.
That's right. We'll be very excited about that. But we will have the latest timing and impacts on the remainder of Winter Storm Olympia, where more than a foot of snow will end up falling by the time we're done tonight. Live look at Duluth, Minnesota right now.
And here's the view for Duluth. It feels like 14 degrees. Duluth, when has it felt warm over the last couple days? The good news is that warmer air is surging. Just be patient.
Listen up. I'm here to get the lady of the house back on her feet and give her the strength and energy to stay healthy. Who's with me?
Yay! The complete balanced nutrition of great tasting Ensure, with 9 grams of protein and 26 vitamins and minerals. Ensure. Take life in.
Meet the lumberjack whose flannel was out of whack. Freedom to move is what he lacked. Even when woodland creatures attack. Until they put Duluth Free Swing and Flannel on his back. With armpit gussets to whack and hack. Now he's known as a lumberjack. Duluth Trading Free Swing and Flannel. Swinging made easy. Flannel made burly. Get it. Only at DuluthTrading.com.
Blizzard of 1978, the one moment that made me a weather geek. When I was a kid, I just was fascinated at the weather. I was fascinated how, you know, I go to bed one night and I look outside and everything is dry. Wake up the next morning, poof, talking close to 2 feet of snow. Wow. Like, how did that happen? And I was just at awe at what was happening with the atmosphere. And I was hooked ever since.
Currently in our area, 71 degrees under mostly cloudy skies. Today, a stray shower or thunderstorm is possible early. Cloudy early with some sunshine this afternoon. High 81. Tonight, some clouds. Low 59. Winds west-northwest at 5 to 10 miles per hour. Wednesday, sunny skies. High 78. Here's our 7-day outlook.
Tidy Cats Lightweight 4-in-1 fights mess right. Attacks 3 strong litter box odors. Plus, locks clumps tight. And now, it's light. Every home, every cat. There's a Tidy Cats for that.
Folks, you can't make this stuff up. 4 bandits chose a Prius as their getaway car.
Bravo, Niner, in pursuit of a Toyota Prius. Over.
How hard is it to catch a Prius? Over.
This thing is actually pretty fast. Over.
Very funny.
Oh, look, a farmer's market.
We should get some flowers for the car. Well,
Toyota, let's go places.
One Crest 3D White smile is all it takes to turn the tables. Crest 3D White toothpaste removes 5 times more stains than the red box. For a smile like that, Crest 3D White is the way to whiten.
At Safelite, we know how busy your life can be.
Oh, no.
This mom didn't have time to worry about a cracked windshield, so she scheduled at Safelite.com. And with Safelite's exclusive On My Way text, she knew exactly when I'd be there. Hi, Steve with Safelite.
Thanks for your text.
I replaced her windshield, and she didn't miss a single shot, giving you more time for what matters most. How'd you do?
We won.
Nice. That's another Safelite advantage.
Thank you so much.
Safelite repair, Safelite replace.
Here in the city, parking is hard to find. Seems like everyone drives. And those who do should switch to GEICO because you could save hundreds on car insurance. Oh, perfect. Valet parking. Hello.
Evening, sir.
Here's the keys. And go easy on the right, mate. Wouldn't mind some of that beef Wellington.
To see how much you could save on car insurance, go to GEICO.com.
Pure is big, bold, and just better. Pure is McCormick. The smallest pinch of Pure McCormick can make meals legendary. We want to help you realize the rich taste that Pure can bring. Because Pure tastes...
Get luxury for less at Alpacker Lincoln. Enjoy incredible savings on Lincoln's best-selling models. Like a new 2016 Lincoln MKZ, just $219 a month. Or a 2016 Lincoln MKC, just $239 a month. Enjoy luxury for less with bottom line windshield pricing. Only at Alpacker Lincoln on Military Trail. And remember,
before you ride, Price Packer.
Hey, how's it going? Hotcakes? Hotcakes.
This place has hotcakes.
Hotcakes.
So why aren't they selling like hotcakes? With Comcast Business Internet and Wi-Fi Pro, they could be. Just add a customized message to your Wi-Fi Pro splash page, and you'll reach your customers where their eyes are already, on their devices.
Order up.
It's more than just Wi-Fi. It can help grow your business. You don't see that every day.
Introducing Wi-Fi Pro. Wi-Fi that helps grow your business. Comcast Business. Built for business.
When the going gets tough, the tough keep pulling.
Stop!
All new episodes of Highway Through Hell, Sunday nights at 10 on the Weather Channel.
Yeah!
And welcome back. It's time now for your winter weather update. As we show you, we look across parts of Buffalo as well as for areas including down towards Erie, right along 90. We're going to continue to see several inches of snowfall. Some of these locations like Buffalo as well as even into Rochester, the Genesee Valley could be picking up about 3 to 5 inches of snow. So we are not done with Winter Storm Olympia just yet. On a wider view, you can see that the snowfall amounts even extend for areas down including parts of PA as well as into West Virginia, up towards the northern part of New York. So even if you're going about your business for today, road conditions are going to be pretty tough because we are still dealing with some icing out there, temperatures still in the 20s, especially across western parts of New York as well as even into PA. For Syracuse today, we have the rain around, and then we're going to see some of that snow as well as that mix starting right around 4 o'clock. So maybe if you're heading home at this hour, expect to see some snow showers around through 9 o'clock this evening. Now here's a view of your radar. And you can see that sharp line between the rain as well as the snow. The snow coming down for areas like Pittsburgh, but north of Pittsburgh, you're going to see even double the amounts that Pittsburgh is going to see. Buffalo, 29 degrees snow for you. That's where we have our Mike Seidel. He's working so very hard. And Syracuse, rain around. And then notice icy conditions for Albany. But look at all the rain. And even in some of these areas where you've seen some of the yellow and the orange, that's where the rain is coming down extremely heavy. Now we go across parts of the Midwest. We do have what is our next little clipper that's moving through. It's going to be much ado about nothing, but overall, even Des Moines this morning, you started off with some snow, saw about an inch, and then for St. Louis, now you're locked into the rain, but southern parts of Illinois, like Carbondale, at times you're seeing some of that mixing, as well as working into parts of Kentucky. So even still, you can see some of that snow just to the east of Paducah, but for Paducah right now, 34 degrees and 36 degrees in St. Louis, so you are comfortably above the freezing mark. Now we timed this out for you today. Here comes our clipper making its way. It's going to be diving arriving down towards the south, as well as making its way over to the east. Now you're thinking, well, is this going to be more snow for us? Overall, it's going to kind of bring kind of that secondary push of cool temperatures in place. So tomorrow, it's going to be kind of the transition day before we see those warmer temperatures arriving by Thursday. Here's 6 o'clock. This is for Nashville. Expect to see potentially some rain around, and even some of those higher elevations could be might see some snowflakes or two. Overall, that looks to be a pretty quiet forecast from parts of the Midwest. Right now, we'll send it over to Allison. She's going to talk more about the warm temperatures across parts of the Midwest.
That's right. We'll take a look at your Midwest regional forecast. I want to take a look at some cities, Iowa City and also into St. Louis, that you can see there on your screen. We do still have some snow on the ground in parts of Iowa City. It is 28 degrees, a little too warm for snow right now in St. Louis, 36 degrees. Right now, it's 27 in Chicago, 33 in Cincinnati, but these places are going to be warm. Warming up over the next couple of days. The problem is today, not likely. We're still going to be dealing with some of those colder pockets of air. So Chicago, Indianapolis, Cincinnati, and Cleveland, all still going to be a couple of degrees below normal. But by the time we get to tomorrow, we get to Thursday, and especially as we approach the weekend, we're finally going to be talking about temperatures 10, 15, even 20 degrees above normal. Look at this again, Des Moines, 60 by Friday. And as we mentioned earlier, warm and sunny. You don't usually get both this time of year.
It's so like a 2-for-1 special, Allison.
Indeed it is.
All right, we can see St. Louis still cloudy there, but you're going to be looking at warmer temperatures as well. We do know it's that little clipper that's moving through, but coming up, we're going to talk more about the impacts of Winter Storm Olympia as it moves into parts of the Northeast.
Plus, another active day of severe weather in the South. We'll break down where the threat of the strong storms continue and look back at where they already hit this morning. But right now, we want to take a live look at Rochester, New York. If you can see through the ice and the snow that has kind of developed on the camera, those would
those
be
big
roadways. Yes, there are roadways behind that. Although I'm not seeing too many cars, probably a good thing. Temperature right now, 29 degrees. We can now switch over to New York City, Jen.
Yeah, we look at New York and you look a lot better, even though you're dealing with some fog out. But that's what's going to be happening today as we go through the day because warmer air is moving through and bringing with it some rain. You can even see some of the drops on the camera. They'll be picking up in intensity, some strong winds, and some major delays setting up already for some of the big airports in the Northeast.
Currently in our area, 71 degrees under mostly cloudy skies. Today, a stray shower or thunderstorm is possible early. Cloudy early with some sunshine this afternoon. High 81. Tonight, some clouds. Low 59. Winds west-northwest at 5 to 10 miles per hour. Wednesday, sunny skies. High 78. Here's our 7-day outlook.